Hello friends, and I welcome you all at Circuits Bazaar. And in this video we are going to study anti-sleep alarm project, or you can say drowsiness detector. So this is the main sensor, which is eye blinking sensor of this project. So there are two LED, which is one is photodiode and another is IR transmitter. Okay, and these are the three pins, 5 volt, ground and output pin. And this blue color component is a potentiometer through which you can set the sensitivity of the eye blinking sensor, or you can say you can set the distance of your eyes from the eye blinking sensor. And this is how you can fit the eye blinking sensor in the goggles. So when you will buy it, it will come along with the goggles. This is the Arduino Nano we are going to use. So we will program this Arduino Nano so that it can sense the data of the eye blink sensor. And this is the SPST, single pole single throw switch. And this is the 9 volt battery which is going to provide power supply to our circuit. And this is the battery cap of our project. So there are two wire, we have extended the wire a little bit. And this is the buzzer which is going to create sound, or you can say sound alert for the user. And this is vibration motor. Actually this is mobile phone vibration motor. You can use any type of vibration motor because there are lots of types of vibration motor available in the market, or if you have any old phone then you can use that as well, that motor as well. So these are some of the ribbon wires we are going to use in our projects. So for detailed description of this project, if you want to study this project in depth, then you can go to the circuitsbazaar.com. The link is given in the description below. From there you can go to the blog I have written on this particular project, and you can study in depth about this project. Now we are going to glue the component on the goggle, and we are going to use the heat gun for that. So this is the Arduino Nano. First of all we are going to stick the Arduino Nano on the side of the goggle. So you can program it before sticking it to the goggle, or you can later program it because the USB port is in open space, so you can program it later as well. Now this is the vibration motor, so you have to stick the vibration motor on the side of the Arduino Nano. So this is the best place for this vibration motor. As I already told you, you can use any type of vibration motor. So this is the mobile phone vibration motor of Samsung mobile phone. Right now we are going to stick this SPST, single pole single throw switch as well. So this switch is going to supply the power supply to the project. Wherever you feel comfortable you can place this SPST switch. So I feel comfortable over here, so that's why I'm going to place this single pole single throw switch over here. Right now the another component left is buzzer. So this you have to keep it over here for some time, till the time the glue is going to be hard. Right now this is time for buzzer. So this is the best place above the microcontroller. So this is the microcontroller, and we are going to place on this microcontroller the buzzer. Right, and we will keep in mind that the two pin of the buzzer remains in a position so that you can solder it later. You can place the buzzer in other position as well. As I told you, whatever you are feeling comfortable you can do that. I have changed the position of the buzzer a little bit so that I can solder it later properly. Right now we are going to place the battery. So the Arduino Nano, the vibration motor, the buzzer and the single pole single throw switch is properly connected on the goggle. We are going to use little bit glue on this eye blink sensor as well so that it remains in positions all the times. So now we are going to fit the 9 volt battery on the goggle. So you can see that this is the 9 volt battery. We are going to use the glue. So instead of glue you can also use the double sided tape to stick the battery on the goggle. So I would prefer double sided tape because in that case if your battery get discharged, so you can replace it easily. But if you have glued the battery then you might face problem later to just remove the battery from your goggles. So now you can see that all the main components we have placed on the goggle. So this is the eye blink sensor, this is SPST switch, this is vibration motor, buzzer, Arduino Nano, and this is the battery. So all the main component we have placed. This is the battery cap. We are going to apply the battery cap on the battery so that we can take out power from the battery for the circuit, and then we will make the connection of the project. So connection I have made according to the circuit diagram on my website. So you can surf Circuits Bazaar website, or you can just click the link given below in the description. So I have written a complete in-depth blog about this project. So over there the circuit diagram, theory details, everything is given, like what the type of code we are going to use. So that is simple Arduino Nano code. So everything you will get on my website. So to keep the video short, I'm just skipping this connection part. So after completion of all the soldering and the glue gun process, this is how our project anti-slip detector is looking like. So you can see that battery, the eye blink sensor, buzzer, vibration motor, Arduino Nano, SPST switch, everything we have fit on the goggle with the help of glue gun. So finally it's time to check the live working of the project. So I'm going to check the project in my office as well and in my car as well.